Hi everyone, it's Emmett from Pie My Life Up. In this video, we will be showing you how to set up the qBittorrent web client within a Docker container. qBittorrent is one of the most popular torrent clients that you can use. It is known for both being lightweight and feature-packed. The advantage of using the web client is that you can access your torrent client from any web browser. Combining this with Docker makes it incredibly easy to get up and running in no time. You can even use the Gluetun Docker container and easily route your torrent connections through a VPN. The steps that we are providing in this guide has a focus on Debian-based operating systems such as Ubuntu. Once you are ready to proceed, open up the terminal on your device or connect to it using SSH. Once connected, the first thing we'll want to do is update the package list by typing in sudo apt update and pressing enter. Once the update completes, upgrade any out-of-date packages by typing in sudo apt upgrade hyphen y and then pressing enter. We can now install all the packages we will need to set up qBittorrent using Docker. To do this, type in sudo apt install curl wget and then hyphen y. These next couple of steps will walk you through the quick process of installing Docker to your machine. If you already have Docker installed, you can skip ahead a few steps. Otherwise, type in curl space hyphen S capital L space https colon /// get.docker.com space pipe symbol space sh and press enter. This command uses curl to grab the Docker install script and then executes it directly on your system. With Docker installed, we should add your current user to the Docker group by typing in sudo space usermod space hyphen a capital G space docker space $ symbol then user all in uppercase and then press enter. This will allow your current user to be able to interact with Docker without you having to elevate to the super user every time. As you have made changes to your current user's groups, we should restart your system by typing in sudo space reboot and pressing enter. With Docker now installed, we can move on to setting up the qBittorrent Docker container. To start this process, we'll make a directory where we'll keep the compose file for Docker as well as store its configuration files. Create this directory by typing in sudo space mkdir space hyphen p space /opt/stacks/qBittorrent and then press enter. Now change into this newly created directory by typing in cd space /opt/stacks/qBittorrent. We can now use the wget package that we installed earlier to grab a default compose file that will start up qBittorrent on your system. To do this, type in sudo space wget space https colon symbol /// git.pymylifeup.com /compose/qBittorrent/compose.yaml. We can now open this compose file for editing by typing in sudo space nano space compose.yaml. This file is used to define the qBittorrent Docker container and how it should be run. Here you can see we specify the container name, the fact it needs to restart unless it's been stopped, and then we set some environment variables. This is where we'll need to make our first adjustment. For qBittorrent to run, you are required to accept their end user license agreement. To do this, replace accept EULA with accept. Next, we must set the time zone that qBittorrent will use on your system. To do this, replace the time zone placeholder with a valid TZ identifier. We will link to a list of these in the description below. For our example, we'll be using Australia/Hobart. Underneath this list of environment variables, you can see that we specify the qBittorrent image that we are using for our Docker container. For this guide, we are using the official containers provided through their Docker Hub. Underneath this, we specify the ports that we will want Docker to expose from qBittorrent. The first port that we expose is 6881. This is used by qBittorrent for its peer-to-peer connections. Underneath this, we expose port 8080. This is used by qBittorrent's web interface. Now scroll to the bottom until you find the volume section. The first volume we mount ensures that the config files will be persist between each restart. Directories that aren't mounted to your local system will cease to exist once the Docker container restarts. Our next step is to specify the location where you want your files to be downloaded to. You do this by replacing our placeholder with the full path to where you want your files saved. In our case, we're going to use our user's home directory by typing in /home/pymyubu/downloads. Always ensure that you use the full path and not a relative one. Once you are done, save and quit by pressing Ctrl+X, then Y, and then Enter. With the composed file now written, starting up the qBittorrent Docker container is as simple as writing in docker --compose-up and pressing Enter. The first time we run this Docker container, we will not be putting it into the background as we will require the password that qBittorrent generates on startup. Once qBittorrent is up and running on your machine, you should see a password specified within the command line. You'll want to copy this as you will need it for the next step. To stop qBittorrent from generating a random password every time it starts, we will need to set our own through its web UI. Now open up your favorite web browser and go to http://, followed by the IP address of the machine you're running qBittorrent on, which in our case will be 192.168.0.8, and then :, and then the port 8080, and then press Enter. On this page, you'll want to use the username admin, and then the password that qBittorrent generated when its Docker container started. With this information entered, click the Login button. Now to change the randomly generated password, you'll need to open the settings screen by clicking the cog icon. Now change to the Web UI tab, and then in the password box, type in the password that you will want to use to access qBittorrent from now on. With your password set, scroll down and click the Save button. That is all the configuration we need to do to get qBittorrent up and running with your own password. However, we will want to stop the current container and restart it so that it runs in the background. Return back to the terminal and press Ctrl+C to gracefully stop the container. Once stopped, start it back up again but type in docker --compose-up -d. The -d option basically tells Docker to run this container in the background. If everything has worked properly, you should now see that your container has been marked as started and it hasn't taken over your terminal. Returning back to our web browser, we can now log in using the username admin and the password that we set in the web UI. To show you this in action, we'll now use it to download the Raspberry Pi OS image. As we have the link to the image, we can just click the link icon, copy and paste it into the text box, and then scroll down and click the download button. Our qBittorrent Docker container will now download this torrent file, process it, and then begin downloading it from any available seeders and peers. Hopefully, at this point, you have also managed to get qBittorrent up and running within a Docker container. As you have seen, using qBittorrent within a Docker container and using its web interface is an incredibly straightforward process. If you like this guide, be sure to give us a thumbs up and subscribe. Until next time, have a good one.